Αλληλούια. αμαρτία μου εις τα μαρτυρία σου και εμείς πλέον εξίαν αλληλούια.
Μια κατέσχε με απαρτωλόν τον εγκατελειμόν τον νόμο σου. Αλληλούια.
Αλληλούια. Quicken me your justice.
ψυχή μου και ενέσυσε και τα χρήματά σου βοήθησή μη.
Επλανήτη αστροπατών Απολλώνος ζήτησον τον πουλών σου ότι τα σεντολά σου που και πέρα κόβει.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, δίδαξον με τα δικαιώματά σου τον Αγίον ο χωρός έβρεπη γη της ζωής και τυραν παραδείσου εύρω καγώ την οδόν διά της μετανοίας το Απόλλωνος προβάτων εγώ ημί ανακάλεσε με σωτήρ και σώσον με.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, δίδαξον με τα δικαιώματά σου. Ο πάλε με, εγμιώτος πλάσαμε και εικόνη σου θεία τη γη σας. Παραβάσει εντολής δε πάλι με επιστρέψας εις γυναίξης ελήφθην. Εις το κατομοίο συνεπανάγαγε το αρχαίον γάλλος.
Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your commandments. I am an image of you in this grave of all glory, though I bear the scars of my sins. Master, take pity on the work of your hands, and in your loving kindness cleanse me. Grant me the homeland for which I yearn, making me once again a citizen of paradise.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, δίδαξον με τα δικαιώματά σου. Ανάπαυσον ο Θεός τον δούλο σου και κατάταξον αυτόν εν παραδείσο. Όπου χωρεί τον Αγίον Κύριε και οι δίκαιοι εκλάψουσι ως φωστήρες. Τον κεκυλημένο δούλο σου ανάβαξο παρόν αυτού πάντα τα εγκλήματα.
Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. The tri-brilliance of the Godhead singleness, let us praise reverently chanting. Holy are you, the beginningless Father, the co-beginningless Son, and the Holy Spirit. Shine upon us, who in faith worship you, and deliver us all from the eternal fire. Αλληλούια, δόξα σοι ο Θεός.
Αλληλούια, 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 δόξα σοι ο Θεός.
Αλληλούια, αλληλούια, αλληλούια. Glory to you, O God.
Oh.
Him who has been taken from us, by granting him rest in the unending blessedness.
Ernisti tu profitu portos, evoi mihi ches portos, ke palingat noisa, endis mimasi ke ikon, ta ostata ke himnomena ke ikon. Aratis esti βασιλεύσει στρατιώτη, η πλούσιο υπέρνη, η δίκαιο η αμαρτωλό. Αλλά να πάψουν κύριε με τα δικαίω των πουλών σου ω φιλάνθρωπο.
Αρχικά υπόσταση στον πλατουργό σου γέρο τα πρόσταγμα. Του ρητήρια δεξαράζουν και οραστής και ζώος υπήρξε πίσεως. Ήρθε μου το σώμα διέφρασας, θέλω καλέ με ψυχή τη Θεία σου και ζω εμέση. Κρυώ, Χριστέ, τον δούλο σου, εν χώρα ζώντων, εσκηναίας δικαίων ανάπαυσον.
In your image and likeness, in the beginning, the man you created and you placed him in paradise to rule over your creatures. But deceived by the envy of the devil, he tasted of the fruit of your commandments, he truly violated. Therefore, to the earth from which he came, you condemned him to return, O Lord, and to entrain you for eternal rest.
Κρινώ και οφείλομαι όταν εννοήσω τον θάνατο και είδα εν της τάφης κειμένη την κατοικώνα Θεού. Πλαστήσα την ημινωρεότητα άμμο φωνάδοξον μη έχουσα δίδος. Ω του θαύματος το παιδί μας, τούτο γεγονέ μυστήριον. Πώς παρεδόθη με τη φορά και συνεσέλθει με το θανάτο. Όμως Θεού προστάξει, ως γεγραφέ του παρέχοντος της μεταστάση την ανάπαυση.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίω Πνεύματι. Ο θάνατος σου, Κύριε, αθανασίας γε, γονε πρόξενος. Ήμι γαρε πνεύματι κατετέτης, ούκανο παράδεισος ειν εαυτό. Διότον μεταστάντα, ανάπαυσο. Remember us, Lord, in your kingdom. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they revile and persecute you, and say all kinds of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven. Distinto paradiso Christe politi, e επί σταυρός υβοής αντά, το πνιστητή μου προαπηργάσω, αυτού της μετανοίας, αξίωσον καμέ τον ανάξιο.
Όταν ψήφων δεσπόζαν και των σωμάτων που εν τη χειρή ευνοήμων των θλιβωμένων παραμυθία ανάπαυσον εφόρα δικαίων πόνεται στις αστολός σου.
Μακάριδε γιωμένη ένε και δικαιοσύνης ότι αυτόν εστί βασιλεία των ουρανών Χριστός σε αναπαύσει εν κορασόντων και πείνας παραδείσου ανοίξησι και βασιλεία δείξει πολίτη και άφεση δόη ονείμαντες εν δύο φιλόκριστε.
Μακάρι έστε όταν ανοίξω σύνημας και διώξωση και ύπωση πάντων υλορήμα καρφήμων ψευδόμενη έμε και νεμού. Εξέλθομαι και είδομαι με της τάπης ότι γίνα οστέρα ο άνθρωπος σκολίκον πρόμα και δυσοδεία και γνώμεν της ο πλούτος το καλός ίσχυς και η ευπρέπεια.
Πρώτης εμπιστολής Παύλου
Glory to
pray to you, hear us and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the repose of the soul of the servant of God, Nicholas, who has fallen asleep, and for the forgiveness of all his errors, both voluntary and involuntary.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And the Lord God will place his soul where the righteous rest, and will grant to him the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and the forgiveness of all his sins. Let us ask of Christ, our immortal King and God.
Grant this, O Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God of spirits and of all flesh, who has trampled down death and crushed the power of the devil, and granted life to your world, do you yourself, O Lord, give rest to the soul of your servant Nicholas, who has fallen asleep in a place of life, a place of green pasture, a place of repose, where there is no grief, sorrow, or mourning. Forgive every sin which he has committed in word, or deed, or thought. For you are a good God who loves mankind. For there is no one who lives and does not sin. Only you are without sin. Your righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and your word is true. Let us to Kyrie Vaithor.
Kyrie Vaithor.
Odissi Anastasis. Izoike Makaria Nabapsis. Του κεκυμμέν μου δούλου του Θεού Νικολάου, Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών, και εσύ την δόξα να αναπέμπω. Συν το ανάρχο σου Πατρί και του Παναγίου και αγαθό, και ζωπιό σου πνεύμα την ίδια ή, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Δόξα σοι ο Θεός, σοι ελπίσει μόν, Κύριε, δόξα σοι.
Δόξα Πατρί, Κύριε, ο Θεός, Πνεύματι, και νίκαι, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Κύριε, ελέησον, Κύριε, ελέησον, Κύριε, ελέησον, Πατέρα, ελέησον.
May Christ, our true God, who rose from the dead, has dominion over the living and the dead, as immortal King, through the intercession of his most pure and holy Mother, of the holy and glorious and all-praised Apostles, of our holy and God-bearing fathers, of the holy and glorious forefathers Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, of the holy and righteous friend Lazarus, who was 4 days in the tomb, our Saint Nicholas and Saint Nectarius, the miracle workers, and of all the saints, assigned to the dwelling place of the righteous, the soul of his servant Nicholas, who has departed from among us, granted rest in the bosom of Abraham,
Amen.
And numbered among the righteous.
Amen.
And may he also have mercy on us,
Amen.
And save us, for he is a good God who loves mankind.
Amen.
Αιωνία σου ημνήμη αξιομακάριστε και αείμνηστε αδελφέ ημών. May your memory be eternal. I am a blessed and ever memorable brother. Αιωνία σου η μνήμη αξιομακάριστε και αείμνηστε αδελφέ ημών. As we gather here to pay our last respects to our friend, Nikolaos Niko, I bring you Rika, Caroline, Yannaki, and Dimitri, also the condolences of Archbishop Damaskinos. I bring you the prayers and his thoughts after mentioning that to him. He told me he would have loved to be here, but due to other circumstances that he's got, he won't be able to be here with us. But his prayers and thoughts are with us as we are here today saying goodbye to a special person. Nick was a well-respected member of our community who had a huge heart and was always selfless of his action. He was actively involved with the church and our community. I remember him now, I think from the days that he arrived here from Cyprus, with his brother Dimitri. And I remember those days, the good times that we had together. We all used to go out together and enjoy as young people there. We missed each other for a while, but when I came back from Cyprus again, we started getting together. And I saw in his heart, and I saw in him how close he got to God, how he believed, how he left everything to God, and he was ready, and he was saying to me, even if I die now, that I think it was just 2 weeks before of his passing away that he gave me a call and we spoke about in depth about many, many things. And he was telling me, as we put down the phone, that he says to me, you know, Mother, I'm ready. Even if I go now, in the eyes of God, I'm happy what I've done. I'm happy with my family. I'm happy with my children. And if God wants to get me there, then I'll go there and work there with him, he says. But it's not easy for the family that is left behind. I know for you, Rika, Caroline, Yannaki, Dimitri, even the cousins, Chris and Stephen, Anita, it's not easy for you. I know what a close family you have been. I know how much close you are and how the difficulties that you're going through right now. It hasn't been easy for you the last few months. Losing Nick, and now losing the other Nick as well. And now losing another uncle as well. So I know it hasn't been easy for the family. It has never been. And it's not easy for all of us to try and understand this. But I want to tell you, although we come here in sorrow and we are upset, and sometimes we are asking God the question, why is this happening to us? Why is this happening to me? Why is this happening to our family? These are questions that are difficult to answer for us. But God has got a plan for all of us. And I know the grace of God, He will give us the strength to overcome this. And although we come here in sorrow, we also come giving God thanks and life memories of Nick, and he was happy. And we believe that God, that although through Jesus Christ conquered death, for all of us who believe in God's name. And death in human experience has never been easy. Whether it comes, as I always say, at a young age, or it comes in an old age. Whether it strikes suddenly, like in the case of this family, or after a long illness, it always leaves behind loneliness. It leaves behind tears and longing, for us difficult to understand. But what did the gospel say to them? What did we hear? We are not here to mourn like those who have no hope. We are here to contemplate and to celebrate the life of Nick. And that's what I think he wanted us to do. And we got to remember that wit and humor that he had about him. And this is what we got to remember. When we find ourselves grieving the loss of a loved one, we think also of death as the end. The final words in a great story of someone's life. And we're all scared of death. But Nick wasn't scared. The Bible teaches that the answer to the mystery of death is found in the life of our Lord Jesus Christ. And we've got to believe that, the Son of God. And through his birth, life, death, and resurrection, death itself has been conquered and the power of the grave has been overthrown. Death is not the end, as the fathers of our church tell us. Death is part of the divine relationship between God and us humans. And the scriptures tell us that we share in experience with our Lord Jesus Christ. We share in the suffering realities of this world, but we also share in the glory of heaven to come. We got to know, all of us, and we got to understand that we only here as visitors. And the quicker in our life we realize that we as visitors and we're not here permanent, then we'll understand our purpose in life over here. Our purpose in life is not yet to make a lot of houses and a lot of money and a lot of everything, but to get closer to God, to show love and respect for our fellow human beings. This is what our God wants us. This is the purpose. It is not easy for a family to bury a loved one. But the question, you know, like this, we've been speaking, is it the will of God? Of some say to justify every kind of death. And the sun shines on good people and bad people, and the rain benefits the hard-working, and it also benefits the lazy, the righteous, but also the evil as well. And so death also comes to all of us, good and bad regardless. It may appear that in these sudden experiences of life that grieves us, that our belief that God is near us is threatened. And it may appear that God actually isn't doing anything at all for us. When we see all the bad things that are happening, when we're losing our own people in life, things happen that we cannot control. And some things happen through the actions of other people, and some things in life are never explained. God seems to be silent when we long for his work. But in a moment like this, we need to respond, all of us, with our faith. The Lord challenges us to look deep within us and remember some things that can turn our pain, our grief, our questions and our uncertainties into the beginning of healing in the face of an event like the passing of Nicholas. And in this case of many in our family as well. You know, God hears our cries. Just like I always say, a mother hears the cries of a baby. A tragedy like this one can turn us even more towards the Lord. And our faith can help to bring us through. I know that it might not feel like it right now. But this pain, and I can assure you, will not last forever. I've gone through that. No pain does. And of course, the pain of losing someone like Nicholas, St. Nicholas, and Bob. Their presence will stay with us, but its power, the pain of power, will be softened as well. I know you're the ones, Rika, Caroline, Yannaki, Dimitri, Stefan, Chris, that you'll be able to miss him the most. Because the pain is even more harder, because what a great person that he was. What great love he showed you. And how unselfish he was. And it's difficult to understand because we, you know what? What a great person that he was. And I know you will be the one to miss him the most. No one will be able to replace him, but you must know that he will always be around to protect you and guide you. And you must be sure, as I always say, he's now resting after the last difficult 2 weeks that he had. And I think he's watching over you and praying for you to be strong and to carry on with your lives. You must gain strength and kindness and love from his own kindness that he showed you. May God be with you and may give you the strength to be able to overcome. But all you must know is that your dad, your husband, is in a good place. Can I call Caroline to say a few words as well? Stefan, Chris, Yannaki, you can all come up.
Hello, everyone. For those of you that don't know, I'm Nick's daughter, Caroline, and I would like to start by expressing my family's sincere gratitude over these last 3 weeks. The love, support, continuous messages, food, and flowers that we received every day was incredible. We are surrounded by remarkable family and friends, and for that, we say thank you. To everyone who is here today, and also to everyone who has dialed in from around the world, to pay your respects, we thank you. And I know that my dad is smiling now, looking down on us all together. Dad,
where do I begin? I feel so grateful to have had an angel as my dad. You sacrificed so much and dedicated your entire life to our family. You taught me to be strong, to be generous and selfless, but most importantly, you taught me that family is everything. It was the simple things in life that made you happy and made you smile. Having one of Mom's delicious home-cooked meals, dancing and playing with your grandchildren, watering your lemon trees and olive trees outside in the sun, and just sitting with your family around you in the garden. Dad, you touched so many hearts and changed so many lives for the better. In fact, I know that every single person who knew you loved you. Growing up, we always had cousins and lots of friends staying over at our house. Dad always said that a full house was a happy house. I always thought everybody wanted to come stay at our house because my mom cooked so well and because we were so cool. But later on, I realized and learned that it was because you always left our visitors some money next to their bedside tables, which they saw in the morning when they woke up. Not a day in our childhood passed where you didn't leave us money next to our bed. And you said to us, spoil yourselves today with it. And to this day, you've looked after me like I was still your little girl. Dad, I am so honored to be your daughter. And although my heart is absolutely broken, and I will never wake up feeling whole again, I will do my best to continue to make you proud. And I will make sure that your legacy remains alive. Your grandchildren will never forget you or stop loving you. And I know you will be their guardian angels for life, as you are mine. I promise that your grandchildren will grow up to know and love Cyprus as much as you did. And we will continue to celebrate your incredible life and incredible legacy with all of our family in Cyprus. I promise to always take care of Mom and the boys for you, and I'm at peace knowing you are in heaven, in God's arms now. Dad, I miss you. I miss you so very much. I love you, and you will always be my hero. A message from our brothers, Yanaki and Dimitri. Dad, we love you with all our heart, and we will thank you, God, for the rest of our days for blessing us with a dad like you. We promise to be as passionate about Jesus as you were, and we long for the day when we will see you in heaven again. I've also got a voice note I would like to play for us. It's from our pastor in Cape Town, from my brother's church.
Friends with Uncle Nick through my relationship with Jan and Dimitri. When he started at the Church of the Goodwood Baptist Church. Over the years, we grew to be good friends, getting together whenever he came down to Cape Town, and whenever I travelled up to Joburg, we'd meet at his shop at President Harper's, and I met him one other time at the shop at the Lemon Tree. One thing I never doubted about Mr. Demetrio was his love for Jesus, and how openly and boldly he spoke about the Lord. Showed deep faith, a deep faith that he had. He was always reading a book about biblical prophecy and how that has an effect on the area he grew up, Cyprus. And he'd always speak to me about that. We became good friends, and I was actually planning on meeting up with him when I planned to come down to Joburg this week, but due to circumstances, I'm sure we're all aware, I wasn't able to. Just shows us that the future is far from certain. From what I've heard about Uncle Nick, and what I've heard what happened in, while he was in hospital, even in his last moments, he was appealing to those who were treating him to repent and trust in Jesus. He knew that he was a sinner, and that he was saved by Jesus' kindness. And that amazing person that we all knew that he became was as a result of the Holy Spirit's work in his life, which empowers us Christians to obey God's word. It is difficult to try and understand why Uncle Nick had to pass away like this, and there is no easy answer. But as his family, please find comfort in the following words of 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 13 to 18. These are the words of Paul. Brothers and sisters, we do not want you to be uninformed about those who sleep in death, so that you do not grieve like the rest of mankind, who have no hope. For we believe that Jesus died and rose again, and so we believe that God will bring with Jesus those who have fallen asleep in him. According to the Lord's word, we tell you that we who are still alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will certainly not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will come down from heaven with a loud command, with the voice of the archangel, with the trumpet call of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. After that, we who are still alive and are left will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. So we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. In my years of officiating memorial services and serving as a pastor, I've seen many people come to faith at memorial services. And I wonder whether the purpose behind godly people like Uncle Nick passing away so tragically is so that their loved ones could come to embrace Jesus as well. That those he loved so dearly would worship the same Savior that he served. Perhaps what we see in what we have seen is a fulfillment of John chapter 12, verse 24, where Jesus said the following, "Very truly I tell you, unless a kernel of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains only a single seed. But if it dies, it produces many seeds." I can't even imagine the pain that you as a family are experiencing. Please find comfort that Uncle Nick is in the warm embrace of his beloved Savior, that he loved so passionately for so many years. Your loss is great, and our prayers and good regrets to Church are with you.
I believe that I have to stand here today to talk about another amazing person that the world has lost. Uncle Nick was an incredible father, not only to young Dem and Caroline, but he was also a father to myself and Chris. We loved and respected him, and we knew that he was always there for us, no matter what. The past few months have been incredibly hard for us all. However, Uncle Nick really went out of his way to make time for our family, and we'll forever be grateful for this. Uncle Nick was never the biggest or loudest person in the room, but his amazingly good heart and honest personality is what made him stand out in the crowd. He loved everybody and always cared for people. I've heard so many stories of how he helped people and what he did to try and make sure that people in need were looked after, and this is why he was such an amazing person and why today is so incredibly sad. Auntie Rika, Caroline, and Mackie Dimitri, I'm so sorry that your dad is no longer with us. But I know that he brought you all up to be amazing people, and he'd be so proud of you all and how you've all come together to support each other during this sad time. Uncle Nick, my mom, Chris, and I feel lost without you now. We're going to miss your guidance in life. We're going to miss having you visit us at work. We're going to miss your positivity. We're even going to miss the way you used to love making sure you brought the lamb extra well done, super close to being burnt. But mostly, we're going to miss having you in our lives. However, I know you're going to be guiding us through life and that you're enjoying yourself with my dad and the rest of the angels in heaven. We love you, Uncle Nick.
I just want to say thank you for Uncle Nick to be in our lives. He was a father to us. My own father said, "Son, if anything happens to me, as your father," and unfortunately he couldn't meet my brother and our babies now, but we know that even the boy is with us, and we've got the two greatest giants walking with us and leading us. He will be in our hearts forever, and for the family in Cyprus, we're going to come pay respect, and we also apologize for the loss of your giant there. And like I said, he was our father. We've got a sister and two other brothers here and another mother. We were so lucky for so many years. But Father Athos is right. He was selfless. They're in a much better place. Their plan was to retire together and come to us. But now they're even retiring in a better place. And we must just be grateful for all the years that we've had. And we all know what a great man he was and how many people he helped. It's just that we feel a bit lost, but we must know that he is with us. And Uncle Nick, I love you with all my heart. You are our father, and we will meet up soon. That's all I can say.
Top two that I really loved about my uncle. The first one was the love and faith he had in God. We shared that very much. Anything we spoke about would last 5 minutes, and we would just sit and speak about God for hours. He loved his family very much. I think a lot of stuff that we spoke about was for everyone just to turn from the evil ways and ask God for forgiveness, but in love, it was never in judgment. Because we knew a lot of things that we prayed about and asked about. The second thing, and one thing that I loved about my uncle is his laugh and his smile. To get him to laugh sometimes, or he would just cry, it was amazing. Sure. His face would just light up, and it lit up my day. On behalf of my mom, sure, her and her brother were very close. They loved each other. whatever they asked each other, they would do for each other. We all have our differences in life, but it was just an amazing bond. For the people in Cyprus that are listening, Sasakapusi Parapoli of Theos, και πίστευε με όλη την καρδιά του ότι ο Θεός σας αγαπάει και το δεύτερο πράγμα είναι αγαπούσα το Θεό μου με όλη την καρδιά μου. Είχε ένα γέλιο ο Θεός μου που φώτιζε το πρόσωπό του και φώτιζε την ημέρα μου. Αγαπούσε τη μάνα μου πάρα πολύ και αυτή τον αγαπούσε πάρα πολύ. So just to end off, I just thank everyone for coming today. Thank everyone for listening online. I'll miss the conversations we had with my uncle, but there's a big part of my heart that has a lot of joy because we spoke a lot in the last 2 weeks and I know he got his heart very clean with the Lord. I know that he's with him. And I'm a straight shooter, so I know that for a fact. And I think for the rest of us that are left here, guys, life is so short, eh? It is so short. If we can just turn and look into ourselves and make sure, just make sure that what we're doing is correct before the Lord. And anything that is unclean, God loves us, eh? And He really wants to clean our hearts up. But we have to be humble enough to turn towards Him and do that. Just that. So ending off, thank you very much. And God bless each and every one of you with wisdom of who He is. Have a lovely day. Thank you.
So my name is Craig, I'm Caroline's husband. I think as Father was mentioned, Nick had a really good sense of humour. I think like a few people would be laughing and smiling now. I think you would actually love it if I could have come up here and actually played Leon Schuster now. You used to love Leon Schuster. You'd love to hear that laugh. You could have heard that. So I've got a few things here that I really liked about and I wanted to share with all of you. The first is picture that my eldest daughter Rafaela drew for him. It's of Dikololo. It's this place that we used to go. We still continue to go. Caroline and her family have been going there for 40 years. She drew this for him. So when he comes out of the hospital, she wanted him to come to Dikololo with her. Okay, so as I say, Nicholas had a great sense of humor, and I think he was the ultimate family man. I think when I realized he had a great sense of humor, and I went to his house to ask for Caroline's hand in marriage. Hard thing to do, and I went and did it, and when I went back to work, Caroline phoned me like an hour later to say, "What are you doing at my dad's house?" I said, "What do you mean?" "No, my dad told me you went there to go and ask for my hand in marriage." I was like, "I can't believe he actually phoned and told you that." She's like, "No, but he really wanted to check if it was okay with me as well." And I think that sums him up. So I thought this was funny, but I also thought it was amazing that he actually did that. And then when we got engaged, we went to Schlange, when we came back, I think Rika was visiting Annie, or she wasn't in Joburg at that stage, so Nick said he had to come around and make us a dinner. And Kay's like, "Please just eat whatever it is, it's just eat whatever he brings." So he arrived at our house with a whole lot of lamb chops and a big thing of olive oil. And he went and he probably put a litre of olive oil into a frying pan and fried all of these chops up there. They weren't the greatest tasting things, but it's one of the few meals that I actually remember. You know, I've had so many better meals, but it's such a special thing that he went and did it. I appreciated that he was able to go and do something like that for us. The next thing with it's called Mbapur, is that every day is a birthday. I think we really grappled to explain to him there's a difference between birthday, Christmas, and Easter, because every single time he came to our house, he used to bring presents for the girls. Every single time. I think he's the most generous person I've ever met. They had a hard birthday time because then our girls are like, "Oh, is this all we're getting this time?" So, but I really appreciate that he used to do that. Another thing is when I first went away with the family to Dikalolo, you know, you're trying to be sort of tough in front of your father on the door and stuff like that. It was a freezing day like it is now. And Nick was lying in a single bed watching the TV. I think we were watching Wimbledon at that stage. We were cold and Ken and Mom had gone for a walk somewhere. He told me I must come and lie with him in the bed there. So I had to come and lie in the bed like with my father-in-law watching TV. But it was just such a special thing, you know. He was just such an easygoing guy like that. Another thing is that he was so proud of his children. He was so proud of Claire and Dominia. I think the things he used to tell me, they could do in their sleep, but he was still so proud of them. He used to tell me, Caroline works in a bank and it was the most amazing thing, you know. The boys, their tennis and they worked in the shop. There's things that they could do in their sleep, but he was so proud of every little thing that they could do, yeah. And I used to really enjoy him coming and telling me these stories about his fantastic children. I think Nick for me embraced, if you stand for nothing, you'll fall for anything. And yes, we've spoken around his beliefs, but I think the other thing around him was that he had certain quirks that you couldn't get around and used to stick to it. And I think three of them that always stuck to me is, any time is a good time to have a souvenir. Okay, so those of you who don't know what souvenir is a very, very strong beverage. He used to have it in the morning, he used to tell us it would beat off flu. You know, we always used to have the souvenir with him, and I used to love that, the way he used to do that. The other thing that he used to do is, he used to tell me, you eat when you're hungry. So even if we'd sat and prepared this incredible five-course meal, Nick would arrive at our house 10 minutes before we'd just serve dinner, and he'd just arrive there with a burger, and he'd eaten a burger, he wouldn't have dinner. He just didn't mind about things like that. You know, if he wanted to eat, he would eat. The next is he loved a good sleep every now and then. So you know, he'd tell us we want to go for a walk, we're all going for a walk now. So we all get ready, you know, get the kids together and everything. And as we're about to go, he'd go sit down and have a nap. He did things the way he wanted to do things. I think that's something we must all learn. You must do what you want to do with your life. That's the way Nick did it. And I know Rika, Kat, Tim and Nyan, I know it's very, very difficult for you guys, but what I can tell is, if you look at the way your dad lived, he created so much support. You know, we're all going to be there for you guys going forward. You know, you can say thanks to your dad. You guys have such a fantastic support base. You know, the way your dad lived, he created all of this. And finally, I do believe that when Nick is in heaven, he's in a form of Dikalolo, where Rick is actually listening to him for the first time, and he's enjoying that. I think young people finally shaved their beards, you know, eating the meals that were put in front of them. And that Kaz overachieving and winning all of the youth activities that she does. And even I just step aside and let him actually light the braai and cook the meat and everything like that. So yeah, guys, we're going to be okay. And we love you, Bapu, and we'll see you sometime, just not yet. Thank you.
Thank you.
Brethren, let us give one final sign of affection to the departed, even as we thank God, for he has now left his kin and hastens towards the grave, no longer troubled about vain things and the toilsome body. We are now family and friends, even now we take leave of him, asking the Lord to grant him rest. Brethren, what is this parting? This waiting, this grieving, at last turning point. Come now, let us greet him, who was but now one of us, but he is consigned to the tomb, to be covered with the stone. Darkness is his abode, and the dead his companions. All of us, family and loved ones, are now parted from him, whom we entreat the Lord to repose. Mother of the unwilling Son,
may I have the pallbearers, please.
Earth Keeper of God, save those who hold you. We ask that by your prayers you will entreat all the gracious one to give grace to the departed one, where the souls of the just repose. As an everlasting memorial, all pure one, declare him and heir to three divine blessings in the count of your righteous. Amen.
Blessed Holy.